San Francisco has long been home to the unique and unusual. We've come to find hope at San Francisco's Ocean Beach, where, almost hidden behind the famous cliff house, stands a small building, a camera obscura, or giant camera. We're here to meet David Warman, the man behind the giant camera.
Hi, have you seen this before? This is a camera obscura. It shows you the whole area here magnified, and it's projected down upon a giant parabolic screen that rotates in a circle very slowly and brings things up close so you get a real good view of what's happening outside right now. It takes about 6 minutes. Here's our policy. Money back if not delighted. I think you'll enjoy it. If you don't, I'll refund your money. It takes about 6 minutes. Ladies and gentlemen, what you're seeing on the screen before you is a reflection of what's happening outside at this very moment. The image is caught by the rotating pyramid on top of the building and reflected down by a mirror through two lenses onto the parabolic or curved screen where you see the focused picture.
Every day, David is out welcoming tourists and local San Franciscans, anyone who wants to enjoy a nearly forgotten sort of entertainment, or just to meditate on the peaceful sounds and reflections of the world outside.
When Playland at the Beach was torn down, very few people came to this area, and the camera obscura was closed up for a long time. I heard that the federal government wasn't too interested in keeping the camera here, so some friends of mine and I got together and we reopened it. We got people involved like Ansel Adams and the Academy of Science and the Exploratorium, and over 10,000 San Franciscans and people from all over the world signed our petition to put this on the National Register of Historic Places. Mayor Dianne Feinstein and the Board of Supervisors voted unanimously to make this a national monument, and they hardly ever agree on anything. Hi, did you enjoy the show?
Oh, it was wonderful. I loved the music and the narration. It was really great.
Tell your friends for us.
Okay, I will.
As a former carnival magician and fire eater, David is no stranger to entertainment. He continues to entertain, both with his giant camera and occasionally with fire eating demonstrations.
Afraid of fire. The fire department goes by and everybody turns their head. Fire gets people's attention. There's a reality in fire. It gets your attention. It's important. And I guess it's the importance of the reality and the illusion of the calamity that might take place any moment that causes people's interest in fire. I know that's what caused mine.
Illusion and reality are the tools every good magician uses to surprise and entertain. Here at the giant camera is proof. The old magic is still alive.
People have asked me why I'm an entertainer or why I try to entertain, and I guess it's because I wasn't a very good student in school and I tried to trick the teacher into thinking I was smart. And people think you're smart if you can do something they can't figure out, and maybe that's what it is. But I'm really quite an ordinary person, and anybody can do the job I'm doing. It just takes a little determination and some stick-to-itism.
America Gentry, and you're jacked into User Friendly, the virtual rehab program where you are the star. Today's program is sponsored by CyberSave, your cyber savior in power shopping. It seems that contraband chip abuse is becoming more and more a very real problem, leading to the rapid decline of decency in our nation. Today we are speaking with two users.
Miss Hyundai Han.
And
Mr. R.J. Mollaposey. Mr. R.J. Mollaposey.
Do chips fill an emptiness in your life?
Well, sure. I'm not saying that I'm not grateful, but I got a job, and when I get home at night, I need to relax. So I use a couple of three chips just to calm down. I've got to program 5,000 robo-flippers every day across the Burger Bob network, so my job is never done. The only way I can calm down after all that anxiety is virtually.
Now, we all know the first step toward chip abuse rehabilitation is to live life one day at a time. If you can get through that one day, well, you're doing better than most of us, because we're not supermen or women. And in order to remind ourselves of this, we must first acknowledge the flag, the heraldry of our country, the United States of America, as a force more powerful than you or I, or any simple, weak human being. Join me, please, as we recite the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God.
Welcome, folks. The name of this game is 7-Card Low Chicago. 8, tray of clubs, a jack for the gentleman, and a bullet for the dealer. Dealer bets 10.
Sounds good.
Right.
States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, liberty.
What? You're bluffing. Bullshit. All right. I'll see your 100 and raise your 100.
Okay, partner, I'll call your bet. What do you got?
Kings over fours, beat them!
Sorry, Charlie. Aces and eights, dead man's hand. Thank you, gentlemen, ladies. It's been a pleasure.
I'm sorry, but you have exceeded your fresh card credit limit. In order to add additional fresh fruit units to your fresh card, you may make a deposit at any Fresh Corps, Auto Bento. Thank you for using Fresh Card.
Life is short. An old retort.
Oh yeah, that's
expensive. I say it every day. It's true. What can you do? People go away. We come to see, smell the air, and find some things aren't very fair, and then we leave between. It is true. What can you do? People go away.